Hello, sun. Hurry up and rise and make the day as hot as you can. If you make the day very hot, I'll be able to sell a lot of water. The more money I bring my wife, Marquita, the better for our little ones. Hurry. Come out quicker, sun. Shine stronger. Please, be a good friend to me. I beg you. The sun is bright. The world is bathed in light. We walk along and sing this merry song. Water! Water! Buy a glass of clear water. All day I spend with my four-legged friend. With KRONER, there's naught for me to fear. What's that? What are they going to punish her for? What did she do?
Don't you know? She tried to conceal a Moor in her house.
A what?
A Moor. An infidel.
Oh, good heavens, please save us from the Inquisition.
One more trip to the well, Peco, and I've earned a Sunday dinner for the little ones. That's fine. Now nobody will buy any water from us. It makes no difference to you what my Marquita says. But how about me, huh? Who are you? Answer at once, or I'll die of fright.
Come here. Closer.
What do you take me for?
Oh, it's so difficult for me to speak.
A Moor. Are you actually a Moor, or are you a ghost?
I'm not a ghost at all, good fellow. I'm just weak with illness. Please do not betray me to the Inquisition.
Of course not. I'm Pedro, a poor but honest man.
Listen to me, Pedro. Please help me to get to the city. I'll pay you for it.
Pay me? Do you mean to insult me?
Oh, no, Pedro. But I'm a Moor. Do you realize what will happen to you if you are seen with me?
I know. Don't worry. You get on the donkey. Well, here we are. If only the barber, Federico, doesn't see us. I hope Marquita doesn't wake up. She's a good wife, but she's a woman.
Who did you bring to the house so late at night?
Be calm now. He's a sick man, a wanderer.
No, I want to see who it is.
He hasn't a friend or a family.
He's a Moor.
He's a human being.
Do you want to become acquainted with the Inquisition?
Pedro. Pedro.
What?
I'm afraid that my end is very near. I bequeath you this little box for your kindness when you open it.
God is merciful. It'll still be of use to you.
When you open it.
He's dead. God help us.
I feel so sorry for him.
You should be sorry for us. We'll be sent to prison for giving shelter to a Moor. Take the corpse outside at once and bury it somewhere.
Shall we begin, Senor Judge?
Anything of interest that you can tell me?
Yesterday, the Toreador Castellaros killed two bulls and wounded a third. The fourth bull killed Castellaros. Jose Antonio, a traitor and heretic, was burned on the eve of Holy Sunday. Robbery, murder, burial, all in one night.
What was that you said?
Pedro concealed a Moor, then murdered, robbed, and buried him.
And all in one night?
Yes, and I know the booty was a big one.
Naturally. Otherwise, there'd be no point in murdering the wretched heretic. Now, Pedro will have to answer before me for his actions.
Do you know how highly I esteem justice?
Everyone knows, Your Honor. It's weight in gold.
Listen, you cutthroat. It won't help to deny your guilt. I know everything.
I swear to God, we're not guilty.
The person that you murdered in your house was a Moor, an enemy of our faith. The gallows, that's the proper reward for a hideous crime like yours. But we shall consider that you murdered the Moor in a passion of Christian benevolence. You understand, my son?
Understand, scoundrel!
And for that, the court will be lenient to you.
Return the property.
And we'll drop the case.
I swear for the salvation of my soul. I didn't commit any murder, and he had nothing at all, except a small redwood box, which he willed to me.
Why didn't you say so, you cutthroat?
Where's that redwood box?
Where is it?
Where'd you conceal it, villain?
Where is it?
With the donkey, Your Honor. With my donkey, in one of the baskets.
You think, my boy, that you can fool us?
Just hang him.
Release him. Keep an eye on him.
Well then, water carrier, this is your good fortune. I'm releasing you in goodwill and peace. And you can take your silly box as well.
But in payment for all the expenses and fees of court, this court withholds your donkey named Pecco.
Don't take Pecco. We have children.
Everyone has.
Please, can't we do it the other way around, Your Honor? We'll take the donkey with us, huh? And leave you this silly old box.
We don't barter here, my boy.
Gone. Gone. Get out.
You dirty scoundrel. That's the kind of a judge you are. To plunder a poor man like I am. To deprive me of my only means of making a living. He takes away my only friend. My Pecco. I miss you so, my faithful friend. My heart is full of sorrow. The world to me seems at an end. Will fate be kind to us tomorrow? You found no happiness, alas. Your life was never really mellow. Though you are nothing but an ass, you've got more sense than any fellow. I don't regret having been honest with that poor old Moor, but to get a box like this instead of my donkey, and to have to drag water on my own back, no, it's too much. Holy Virgin, the Moor!
That which is written on the parchment is magic to me. Abel, Raheben, Atzing, Abel, Raheben.
Abel Ra Ibn Adsin Abel Ra.
Very good, but not so quickly. When the clock strikes midnight, take a candle in one hand and the parchment in the other.
What goes where?
Don't ask silly questions. The candle and the parchment will reveal to you.
Will reveal to you.
Not to me, but to you.
Oh.
Will reveal to you the place of the hidden treasure.
What? Oh, a treasure.
So that's it. It means you think the only reason I saved you was in the hopes of getting rich.
Don't interrupt.
No. If that's what it is, then there's nothing to talk about. Go away.
Please don't interrupt me. Be quiet and listen. When you finally get down to the cave and the clock strikes 12, the candle will light up. Say those magic words, and the door to the cave will open, and you will be able to enter. But woe unto you if the candle is extinguished. The walls will close, and you will be left there with the treasure.
11 and 12. Ah, bell rock, even odd sing, ah, bell rock. Good evening, most respected signors, good evening. I hope you don't think I've come here on my own. You see, I have the candle, and I have the parchment, and I remember the magic words very well. Now, why don't you say something, huh? You are enchanted, yes? Does that mean yes? I'd better hurry, or the candle will go out. Oh, if you only knew how happy my wife will be. And the children, they'll be so delighted. This coin will go to the oldest boy, Juan, for a horse. This one goes to Lucinda for a doll. And this one goes to Pedro for a ball. And this is for our Peco, for oats. And this necklace is for Marquita, my beautiful wife. Now all of Granada will admire my Marquita. You are still silent, senors. Goodbye, then. I hope we'll meet again. Quiet, quiet. Marquita mustn't know anything about this. Hey, be quiet. Not a word to Marquita.
You've come home? Hey, wonderful. You've even dared to return at all, after gallivanting all night long.
Don't be angry. I've been thinking of you.
You've been thinking of me? How grand. It's a wonder you didn't bring home another Moor to help you along.
So you're making fun of the Moor and me. You know what, then? I swear that you won't tell a soul.
I wouldn't think of it.
You won't even think of it?
No, I won't.
All right, then. All of this is for you. Here. Here. Take it.
Holy Virgin, have mercy on me. What have you done? Oh, I am an unfortunate woman. Is it possible that I've been married to a robber? To a bandit? Well, why don't you answer me? Do answer me.
How lovely you are. How beautiful you are, Marquita. Only remember, not a word, my dear. Not a single word to anyone.
Turns out that you are a scoundrel, my son. You said that the infidel whom you had concealed, then murdered,
did not leave anything but an empty box?
And now your wife, dressed in her rags, is flaunting pearls and diamonds.
You disgusting liar.
Prepare to return the booty or swing on the gallows.
Answer and be quick about it. How big is the treasure?
And will you return my peco?
Who's that?
Your Honor, the donkey.
What?
I mean the donkey, Your Highness.
That's better.
Everything has to be divided evenly. Otherwise, the treasure will be lost.
Promise him anything. Anything he wants, and then...
This very night, we'll divide the treasure evenly, you follow me. But if you're lying, don't expect any mercy.
And 12. Ah, bell, ra. Even Hudson, ah, bell, ra. Go right in, Senor Judge.
No. Why should I be the one to go in first?
Then you go ahead, Frederico.
No, I'd rather wait right here.
You go in first, Pedro, and we'll wait for you here.
Very well, as you prefer.
My peco, you've come.
Well, come on, brother. We'll bring the signors as much gold as we can carry.
Now we know the way. And if he actually brings the treasure, then... You know what to do.
We'll thank him just as he deserves.
Here, take it.
Look at that. He didn't lie.
It's gold.
It's real Moorish gold. I've never seen so much before in all my life.
You go down at once and bring the chest right here.
No, thank you, senors. We have enough, Peco and I. It's your turn now.
And who's Peco? Now I know.
All right, then. We'll manage to bring up the chest without your aid, and you'll get nothing out of it.
Follow me, senors!
Now's the time. See, fate is on my side.
Well, that's all, my peco. Don't be afraid. You'll never again see those three horrible signors. And now it's time to return. Hurry, let's go. The sun is bright, the world is bathed in light. We walk along and sing this merry song. Water, water, buy a glass of crystal clear water.
Pedro's here again.
All day I spend with my four-legged friend. With Pedro near, there's naught for me to fear. Water! Water, buy a glass of crystal clear water, fresh water. Goodbye, dear son. Goodbye, my friend. Until tomorrow.